I felt comfortable. First round, second round, I thought it's going to be a walk in the park. But with the Thais, what they do is they pick it up in the final few rounds, which now, obviously, with experience, I will keep in mind. In the third round, ref said break, touched my back, and I felt like I got caught with an elbow that sort of lost my feet. End of the third and the fourth, I thought, I'm playing his game now. I'm fighting how he wants me to fight.
John wanted to go in there and prove he can stand there toe-to-toe, and he can. Just a slight lapse in concentration. Rodtang done what he done best. He loves being in the pocket. He loves being toe-to-toe. That's where he's the most comfortable. And that's where he caught John with a lovely overhand right. John done brilliantly to recover. Really professional, took his time. Didn't get up straight away. Took the count, got up just at the right time and went back to work like a pro.
In the first two rounds, what I was doing was footwork. Should have been doing that, really. Got my head back on the fifth. Thought I took the fifth. Bit too late though. The knockdown, obviously, is what they look for, the damage. Fair play. They gave me the immediate rematch, which I'm very thankful of. But in my own head, I had to turn it down. I wasn't mentally ready. Still recovering from the loss. I was assessing things. When you're not 100%, you don't want to jump in these things. I've jumped in things before, not 100%, and it hasn't been the outcome that I've wanted. I don't think it was anything special. He hit me with like three good shots that I felt technically, been in there with better people. Now is the right time. I know when's right. Come January the 10th, this will be the right decision that I made.
Inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. This one brought to you by Hobbs & Shaw. Champion from the UK, left of screen, the challenger from Thailand, right of screen. They exchange round kicks early. Look for the elbows, look for the front kicks. There's one from Haggerty. Look for the sheer brute power of Rodtang. Inside leg kick from the top. More than 140 martial arts world champions on the roster at one championship. You are seeing two of them in the ring at the moment.
Go!
Got to wonder. And Rodtang maintained his composure. High check there. Jab two from Haggerty. That's the precision. That's the excellence of execution from the general.
Good work so far from Haggerty, especially with these kicks, man. And that's what he's doing. He's laying that bait. Now he landed a few push kicks, and now he's starting to fake the push kicks. And that's how he sets up those elbows. He slides in forward and throws those elbows off of that fake push kick.
The push kick of Haggerty, one of the best in the business. Pulls the toes back, extends the ball, the foot drives it into the midsection of the opponent. Roundhouse kick from Haggerty. And there's the push kick, and it's sent Rodtang back against the ropes. Again, the succulent technique of the 22-year-old world champion from the UK. Front kick again from Haggerty. Scoring points. We do have three judges ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points per round. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. At the moment, with the front kicks, it's Haggerty doing the scoring.
Rodtang's having a hard time with the range of Haggerty. That lead push kick is causing a lot of problems for Rodtang. Rodtang's not used to just standing there taking these shots. He's usually the one pushing forward, throwing those shots.
He is landing every one of these front kicks. There's a downward elbow, hoping to crack the collarbone. When we spoke to Haggerty yesterday, we said, what were you most looking forward to about competing against Rodtang? He said, I can't wait to kick him. I can't wait to front kick him. And he's done plenty of that so far, with 45 seconds remaining in the first round set for five.
It's all those, I like that little change, that little stance change that he does as he throws that right kick.
Haggerty's flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line. There's a front kick off the lead leg from the general. Nice 3-2 combination. Inside leg from Rodtang, the Iron Man. Both wearing the Project armbands, a little more flamboyant. Those around the left bicep of Haggerty. The more super Project around both the biceps of Rodtang. All part of the tradition, the custom, the superstition of Muay Thai, a martial art dating back some 3,000 years. Front kick again. Punches up at his right. Into the round, we go to the towers. Now once again, give the winning boxer of the round 10 points. The most dominant boxer of the round, 5 points. We are scoring on a 10-point must system.
Look at that beautiful left high push kick, fakes it, and puts the rope save Rodtang from ending up on his butt there. Just that timing is just beautiful coming from Haggerty. He took advantage of the slow start from Rodtang, and that was an exceptional round for Haggerty.
Now we will say that traditionally the Thais do start very slow. The reason being, however, in Thailand is that betting is done ringside on the contest, not permitted, of course, here in one Super Series. There's no live betting here ringside, but that's why they start slowly in Thailand. So a lot of Thai combatants you do see start very slow in the first, second rounds of a five-rounder like this is, and really pick up the pace in the third round onwards. So a very slow first round from Rodtang, but over 5 rounds, as we're scheduled here, maybe to be expected.
With over 300 matches, you think it's hard for him to break that habit of traditionally having a slow start?
And usually in one Super Series, he's used so far to having 3 rounds, where there's not much time for a filling out process, not much time to wait and see what your opponent's got to offer. You've got to go hell for leather from the opening bell. But here we have 5 rounds. Front kicks again from Haggerty. Checks the inside leg kick. Rodtang, you feel, is just trying to get his timing off that front kick to work a counter. Maybe it'll be a big overhand right. Maybe it'll be a hooking punch. But that's what he's going to try and time off, the front kick of Haggerty. There you see it again. A catch and counter, scooping to the liver section.
Now he catches it. Now you're starting to see Rodtang. You can see him at the end of that first round kind of pounding his chest, firing himself up, shaking his head. That's the Rodtang we're used to seeing.
There is a moment in previous contests we've seen where Rodtang goes from Bruce Banner to the Incredible Hulk. Are we going to see it here in the second round? We will see it later on. Nice, hook to the outside leg kick there from Rodtang. Haggerty switches stance, southpaw now. Front kick off the back leg, now back to orthodox. Very tight in his guard here, Jonathan Haggerty, the 22-year-old world champion from England. Sticks the front kick into the guts again of Rodtang. Good outside leg kick, hard the thigh there from Haggerty.
Rodtang's starting to evade a lot of these kicks now. He's moving his head a lot better, getting out of the way of these. I think he's starting to figure out the reach there. You can see just how long the leg reach, the advantage that Haggerty has. And Rodtang's starting to figure it out a little bit more. Expect Haggerty to start going to the legs and body a little bit more.
Rodtang has the edge in power, but Haggerty, it looks like, has the edge in speed and precision. Down to the elbow, looks for a dump from Haggerty. The blow there off the referee Onari went to break them, and Haggerty complaining to Onari there.
Yeah, but it wasn't quite really a break. Like, the referee was there, but he didn't really have his hands in there separating them. So, I don't know, maybe it was the angle that I didn't quite see, but it looked like Onari wasn't really trying to break them.
Front kick there from Haggerty. Once again, folks, make sure you follow ONE Championship across all social media platforms on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. A lot of fans watching tonight. Big hello to Mauro Pomali watching in Tuscany, Italy tonight. High kick from Haggerty. Trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Outside thigh kick from Rodtang. Now we're seeing Rodtang raise the mercury, raise the temperature, raise the aggressor meter.
This is what Rodtang has to do.
I'll take my feet.
This is what Rodtang has to do. He cannot allow Haggerty to push forward and be this aggressive. He's got to slow Haggerty's aggression down, cut him off, start putting heat on him.
Two down, 3 remaining. 4 ounce gloves in a 5-round world title match. Once again, folks, whoever was the dominant boxer in the second round, give them 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. A beautiful horizontal elbow there from Rodtang, but was it a little late?
Now, I don't know, man. You can see the referee was just kind of standing there. He didn't have his hands in between. You got to go until the referee tells you to stop, and I think Onari just kind of tapped him on the sides there, and he let him continue. That's when that elbow came.
Now it's all part of one championship tour. The Heroes live from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. This our co-main event for the Flyweight Muay Thai world title. Sellout crowd tonight, the hottest ticket in town. And Haggerty has had a very good opening two rounds. But this is where we expect Rodtang to start to uncork the power salvos. Start to light the fuse, to pull the trigger. And we know that he can, unlike any other. If Rodtang decides to put the foot down and turn it on, strap yourselves in for the ride of a lifetime.
Well, Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Gyeonghadao. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Gyeonghadao never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
And you see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks like he's returned the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs, and referee Onari breaks it.
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot, not allow Haggerty to go forward and control those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Roger Dunn slipping down. Looks to be leaving there, there's Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes, drifts back clockwise, thrusts out the jab. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down now. He wasn't doing that the first two rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand with a toe-to-toe? Has he going to play that game? Is he going to try to let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Rodtang goes to the liver. Circles off to his left, but he's going into the power side. Another liver shot, like he's digging for oil. This is a great round for Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick, takes the inside thigh kick, goes high, misses the target. Checks the low kick, jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though, gotta get off the ropes though, gotta get off the ropes. And now he does after running it over.
It's a much better round for Rodtang. This is what we'd expect from the Iron Man. To go forward and throw
a downward elbow! And a dump out from Rodtang. Another downward elbow! With submitting intent from Jonathan Haggerty. But we told you Rodtang would wait to the third round and pick up the punch. Indeed, he's done that in true Thai fashion.
But Haggerty's landing shots too. He's landing a lot clearer shots. We're seeing the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and on. But Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab two combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catching dump there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang. A fantastic round from both men. But did Rodtang edge that one?
Much better round for the Iron Man, but Haggerty had his moments in that round. He was still utilizing that push kick, but everybody seems to be impressed by what the Iron Man is doing right here. Look at this big right hand. Boom! Touches the ear. Goes digging for earwax like a Q-tip inside the side of that ear right there. Beautiful work done by Rodtang in that third round. That's the Iron Man that everybody in the world of Muay Thai was so excited to see tonight. Now he's starting to bring it out. Very close. How do you have that? Maybe 2-1, maybe 1-2? Oof, interesting. Interesting. Rodtang's getting fired up though as he stood up on the ring ropes. You rarely see people climbing the ring in the middle of the match.
Haggerty's corner, Knowlesy and the crew telling him, go down the center corridor, use your push kick, use your jab, go to the uppercut elbow, come down the center corridor with a sharp technique. Penultimate round of action for the one Super Series Flyweight Muay Thai world title. Jonathan Haggerty versus Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
I do like the counters of Haggerty so far. I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again. again from Haggerty, finding range outside leg kick from Rodtang. All that pressure. A hooking punches and the power up of the forearms blocks. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick, nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice tip to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick. Threads the jab again. Takes an outside lead kick. Body shots. Oh,
Haggerty's
hurt. Shots hurt him. The liver shots hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. Referee O'Malley puts the count on. Haggerty's up on his feet. But he's been rattled. It was a beautiful hooking punch from Rodtang. And here comes the Iron Man. Here comes the tank. Now he's got an incredible hold. Now the ticking time bomb has exploded. Rodtang marching him down. Eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, stop dancing. Come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. Oh, nice front kick there. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow. Hoping for the collarbone. Jack. But he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, to the left. He's going to go to the right, to the right. Go. Stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. Go. He says, this is for a belt. Come on, let's go toe to toe.
And how about this?
Get into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no, you come on. You bring it. I'm not coming to you. You've got to come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games, though. He's still moving, though. He's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says, let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games. Saying, I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's going to come down to the fifth and final. With that knockdown, Rodtang could have a slight edge in the scoring. If the scorecards, depends on how the judges saw that third round. It's very close right now. Look at him coming forward. Boom! With just a wild hooking combination sends the champion crumbling to the mat as Rodtang starts to turn on the heat. Look at that right hand comes through the guard. And then Haggerty got on his bicycle and starts circling, staying away from him. Keeping the taunting going, keeping it interesting, but you can tell Haggerty was hurt. This is a different Haggerty that we're seeing right now. Haggerty needs to reach down deep, develop that, bring out that champion's mindset, put it all on the line, because I think it comes down to the fifth and final round.
Such amazing respect I have for these two world champions. These two phenomenal athletes. And look at this sellout crowd in Manila at the Mall of Asia Arena, and what a show they've seen. This is one for the ages. Haggerty engaging in the mind games with Rodtang. And there's a moment of respect. The fifth and final round for the Flyweight Heavyweight World Title. They touch gloves. It could be drawn at the moment. Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. I think it changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty cheek down the center. Needs the elbows. 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And the general goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of an opponent is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Tries to push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with his legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah, this
look at
is Haggerty's round so far. No
That's
doubt
scoring,
about it,
Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws two punches, doesn't connect. Tucks the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hooks to the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. There's a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1 minute five remaining, fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab two from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty, it has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologizing. We'll say no, maybe Haggerty accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. And he thread an overhand elbow to the top of the head pads. Or maybe skip in for a downward elbow to the collarbone.
30 seconds, Michael. This is it right here. Last 30.
There's one of these two men pounce on the other now. Jab two, a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice two landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
Haggerty can take this round. It might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws. We are going down to the judges. This is razor close. This is harder to pick than a broken nose. I don't know what to say about this one, Mitch.
If it's harder to pick than a broken nose. If it goes to the judges, if it, that's just scorecards. Your nose thing threw me off. And then right now it could be even. If Haggerty won that round, right now it could be even as a draw. Then it goes to the judges' scorecards. Then you have to factor in who did the most damage. And does the knockdown score the highest? It could go to, oh man, so many variables.
This is close. Wherever you're watching, folks, in over 140 countries around the world, how do you score it? Let us know on social media. Let us know on Facebook. Let us know on Twitter. At One Championship. Sellout crowd in Manila. Loved every moment of it. Chatri Sitjatong there to present the championship bout to either Haggerty or Rodtang. So close, they are still tabulating here ringside. They want to get it right. It could go either way. It really could. Both men 22 years old, phenomenal athletes. It is the match we hope for and a lot more. Both men have their fists raised. Both believe they have won it. The sportsmanship though, they let it all go in the ring and afterwards their mates. That's what true martial arts spirit is all about. That's that honor, integrity, respect, that Bushido code. This one is just razor thin. They are still counting the scorecards, double-checking, triple-checking, quadruple-checking to make sure they get it right. It could go either way. And no matter who wins, I do not believe the other man would be disappointed because it is that close. Who's got it, folks? Rodtang, a veteran of 300 plus bouts. Or do you have it for Haggerty, who's had only, I think, 16 professional bouts? Does Haggerty retain the crown? Does Rodtang take it? They are still tabulating here ringside. Now I see Dom Lau just double checking with officials to make sure on his card what he's about to read is correct. This may very well be the closest decision yet in one Super Series history. Okay, Dom Lau has the decision. Let's go now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And new one Flyweight Muay Thai World! champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
The emotional outpouring. The world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.